Hello, this is Anthony Christie Melson bringing to you solution of partial differential equation by direct integration. As the title suggests, we will be solving partial differential equations by the method of direct integration. As an example, I have chosen solve the partial differential equation dou squared z by dou x dou y equal to 0. Now we can integrate this partially with respect to x or y. Because we are integrating partially with respect to x or y, the other variable or the functions of other variables will be treated as constant. Therefore, when we integrate partially with respect to y, we get dou z by dou x equal to a constant, which can be treated as a function of x. Since x and y are independent, f of x will be constant with respect to y. Similarly, if we integrate partially with respect to x, we get z equal to integral f of x dx plus g of y. Now in this case, g of y is constant with respect to x. If we choose example 2, we have dou squared z by dou x dou t equal to e power minus t cos x. So here we choose to integrate partially with respect to x. This will result in dou z by dou t equal to e power minus t into sin x plus a constant of integration with respect to x, which will be f of t. If we integrate equation 2 with respect to t, we get z equal to minus e power minus t sin x plus integral f of t dt plus constant of integration with respect to t, which is g of x. Similarly, we'll see other problems. The example 3 here, we have x into dou squared z by dou x squared plus dou z by dou x equal to 9x squared y cube. Instead of the usual process, if we look at the left hand side, it looks something like a product rule. Now dou by dou x of x into dou z by dou x gives us x dou squared z by dou x squared plus dou z by dou x. So we can substitute equation 2 in 1, and that results in dou by dou x of x dou z by dou x equal to 9x squared y cube. Now we can integrate this partially with respect to x. The result will be x dou z by dou x equal to 3x cube y cube plus constant of integration with respect to x, that will be f of y. So we divide throughout with x, which results in equation 5. Now we'll integrate equation 5 again partially with respect to x. So that will give us x cube y cube plus f of y into integral 1 by x dx plus constant of integration with respect to x, which is g of y, which further simplifies to equation 7, which is the final solution. Now we have studied solution of higher order differential equation in first semester, so we'll recollect that. Now if I have f of dy equal to f of x, where f of d is a differential operator with constant coefficients, then equation 1 has a solution of the form y equal to cf plus pi given by equation 2. Now to find cf, we need to find an auxiliary equation which is given by f of m equal to 0. Now the roots of the auxiliary equation decides the type or the form of complementary function. If we have distinct roots, then complementary function will be of the form c1 e power m1x plus c2 e power m2x. If we have repeated roots, the repeated root will have the form c1 plus c2x into e power mx, and the other roots will have the type given by the first case. If any of the roots are complex, that is, if we have m equal to alpha plus or minus I beta, because the complex roots always appear in pairs. Therefore, in such a case, those two roots will constitute e power alpha x into c1 cos beta x plus c2 sin beta x. The remaining terms will be according to either case 1 or case 2. Now, the particular integral is 0 if the right hand side is 0, the right hand side of equation 1. So if we have f of x equal to 0, then equation 1 is called as a homogeneous differential equation. In such a case, the solution y will be just a complementary function. And if f of x not equal to 0, we need to find a particular integral depending on f of x. We'll take the example dou squared z by dou y squared equal to z, subject to the condition z equal to e power x, and dou z by dou y equal to e power minus x at y equal to 0. Now, if we choose dou by dou y as the differential operator d, then equation 1 reduces to d squared minus 1 operated on z equal to 0. So we have the auxiliary equation m squared minus 1 equal to 0, whose roots are m equal to 1 and m equal to minus 1. Therefore, the complementary function will be c1 e power y plus c2 e power minus y. Since we are dealing with solution of PDE by direct integration, the constants in the complementary function can be treated as functions of x, because capital D that we chose as the differential operator is dou by dou y. So we replace c1 with f1 of x and c2 with f2 of x. Particular integral will be 0 as the right hand side of PDE is 0. So we have z of xy equal to f1x e power y plus f2fx e power minus y. Now, z equal to e power x at y equal to 0. Using this condition, we get e power x equal to f1 of x plus f2 of x. If we differentiate equation 6 with respect to y, we get f1 of x e power y minus f2 of x e power minus y. Now, using the other condition at y equal to 0, we have e power minus x equal to f1 of x minus f2 of x. Now, equation 7 and equation 9 can be solved to get f1 of x and f2 of x. So the final solution will be cos hyperbolic x e power y plus sin hyperbolic x e power minus y. Thank you.